Welcome to unit 5.5. In this unit we want to look at two of the three modifications of the element carbon, graphite and diamond. Probably most of you know that their properties differ considerably, but why is this the case? Maybe we can understand this better if you have a look at the structure. Well, let's start with graphite. Graphite crystallizes in the space group P63 over MMC. It is composed of these single, planar, so-called graphene sheets, having this nice honeycomb structure. Within such a single sheet, all carbon atoms are chemically bonded to three other atoms in a triangular fashion. These graphene sheets are now stacked along the C direction with a distance of 335 picometers, but not exactly on top of each other, instead with a small offset, so that they build a so-called AB layer sequence, meaning that every second layer is identical. If you looked from above onto two adjacent layers, we would see such an arrangement. And here you can see that every second atom of one layer sits exactly in the center of six atoms belonging to the other layer, and vice versa. These dashed lines mark so-called delocalized electrons. And we see that these lines appear along the whole plane. This is the reason why graphite is a relatively good electrical conductor, but only along this plane. This becomes immediately clear if we switch back to the other view. These layers are only loosely bound to each other by so-called van der Waals forces, but not by covalent bonds. They are relatively far apart from each other, there is no direct link. So this is the reason why graphite is in this direction, perpendicular to the sheets, a very bad electrical conductor. And it is also the reason why graphite shows, in total, a bad thermal conductivity. There are no, in quotation marks, particles which would be able to transport heat from one plane to the other. And this layered structure is also the reason for another property graphite is commonly known for. It is a very soft material. And it is immediately understandable why graphite can be used as a lead in pencils. While we write with a pencil, the friction with the paper leads to a delamination of the single sheets, because they are so loosely bound to the bulk. We can zoom into the lead up to an atomic level. And now, if we draw a line in this direction, these graphene molecules will, one after the other, lay onto the paper. Now the lead is a little shorter and probably we have to sharpen the pencil again. Now let's compare graphite with a girl's best friend, diamond. Here you see one unit cell of diamond. The space group is FD3 bar M, cubic. We see that each carbon atom is covalently, this means chemically bonded to four neighbors in a tetrahedral fashion, which gives rise to a fully connected network in three dimensions. Let's have a look at the slightly extended network. Yes, now we clearly see this fully connected network. And in contrast to graphite, diamond does not have any delocalized electrons. So now we can easily understand why diamond is a bad electrical, but one of the best thermal conductors. And we have a certain idea why diamond is so hard. On this hardness scale of Mohs, diamond has the highest value of 10. Diamond is the hardest mineral known. Although, meanwhile, some man-made materials have been created which are even harder, if only slightly. All atoms are connected to each other in all spatial directions, and the chemical bonds are strong. What we obviously cannot tell by looking at its structure is, of course, its high price. Okay, to slowly come to the end of this unit. Diamond, did we not talk about glide planes, which had been denominated with reference to diamonds? Yes, the glide planes D. If you like, load the sieve of diamond into mercury and have a look at the symmetry elements. Here, all glide planes are depicted. Yeah, looks like a typical cubic mess of symmetry elements.